I missed you, and I wasn't even a Pure Foods fan back in the day. I guess that's the thing about Pure Foods. It's a PBAT built on so much success and even more myth that even a non-fan like me feels a strong connection with the team name. I remember 1988 like it happened yesterday. Pure Foods joined the PBA and they put together an all-star team. They got Ramon Fernandez, JB Yango, Padim Israel, Willie Generalao, Freddy Hubalde, Onche De La Cruz from Tanduay. Then they got young stars Alvin, Jerry, Jolas, Glenn Capascio, Al Solis, and Jack Tanuan. What a team! This is basically like combining the core of Talking Text with the UAAP All-Stars. They were that strong. And the Hot Dogs would practice at the Loyola Center, which is now called the Blue Eagle Gym, and we would go and watch them practice, not to see Alvin, Jerry, and Jolas, but to see the pretty girls from nearby schools who wanted to see Alvin, Jerry, and Jolas. Di ba? Nice arrangement, right? Pure Foods was a multi-spectrum phenomenon in 1988, combining good looks with great players and the birth of a winning tradition. They represented glamour. They represented marketability. They represented winning. And they won a lot. I wasn't a Pure Foods fan, but even I had to recognize a great thing when I saw it. It was unavoidable. It was undeniable. The phenomenon was so strong, we refer to them by their first names. Alvin, Jerry, Jolas. For many of you watching tonight, your Pure Foods Big Three consists of James Yap, Mark Pingris, and PJ Simon. I'm happy that these three have stuck together and have won together for so long. They are no doubt worthy of the Pure Foods myth. But my Pure Foods Big Three, I suppose because of my age, I'm not that old, but because I witnessed how this whole thing started, will forever be Alvin, Jerry, and Jolas. They're still the reason why I get excited when I see the Pure Foods logo. They're still the reason I'm getting excited now that Pure Foods is back in the PBA. I suppose the magic of 1988 never really faded. I suppose the Pure Foods phenomenon of 1988, for those who witnessed it, will always live on.